Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1456, Pivot to Range. Well, hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. I was up in Michigan yesterday doing a seminar for the Detroit chapter of the IIA. Got a lot of great questions there. I'm going to cover two of those questions. First, we have a pivot table here, and if you drill down, if you choose one cell and drill down, you know, you get the new worksheet with all of the records that make up that cell. But starting in Excel 2007, they automatically make that into a table format. And the question is, how do we stop it from doing that? Well, we can't stop it from doing that, but it is just a couple of clicks to go back to a regular table. First of all, get rid of the formatting if you don't like the formatting, and then right here, convert to range. Do we want to convert the table to a normal range? Well, yeah, that's why I click the icon. And so then you get just a regular spreadsheet. Kind of a hassle is you have to do that every single time, but you have to do that every single time. And then the next question was, okay, I have a pivot table and I'd like to unpivot that pivot table. In other words, convert that pivot table to a range. I said, okay, you know, easy. Select the whole thing, copy, and then paste as values. She said, but then I lose the formatting. I said, all right, easy enough to get the formatting back. Let's do Control T for a table. And then we can go back here to the quick styles and choose one of the settings, and also you then have banded rows and so on, just like you would be able to do in a regular pivot table. All right, so that was good. But then she came back and she said, wait a second. It's not the formatting that I'm upset about. It's the fact that I'm losing these formulas. These formulas go away when I convert it back to a range. I said, okay, well then what we're going to have to do is we're going to come here to the actually, we're going to just take the east, central, and west and make that not have subtotals anymore. All right, so here's how we do that. Under the Options tab, Active Field, Field Settings, Subtotals, None, click OK. Of course, it also makes a lot of sense to go back here to the Design tab, Report Layout, and say Show in Tabular Form, so that way we get those filled in. And then also, this is Excel 2010 only, repeat all item labels to fill in that data. Grand Total, off for rows and columns. So now we just have what I call a flat pivot table. Now that we've done that, let's convert that to values. So copy, paste as values, and then simple enough to do data subtotals. At each change in region, use the sum function for these fields. Click OK, and you get back to the formula. So whether it's the formatting or the formulas that you want to keep, there are ways to get back to those. Okay, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another Netcast. Mr. Excel.